Hi students, good morning to all of you. Today I am going to start a chapter, life process. Okay, first of all our focus is that we should learn what is life process. For what topic we are going to discuss about that? Life process is that process like growth, like excretion, like respiration, like circulation. These all process that we are doing in our daily life, they are known as a life process. So all the living things perform certain life process like growth, excretion, respiration, circulation, etc. All the process like respiration, digestion, which together keep the living organism alive and perform the job of body maintenance are called life process. And we know that if we are not performing the respiration, if we are not able to perform the circulation, excretion, if any process is stopped, our life will not in a regular way, we are not able to survive, right? So I can tell these processes are very necessary for the survival of any living organism. So I can also tell in this way ki these processes are very essential for the life. That's why they are known as a life process. Okay, now here in a chart, if you see here, it is explained life process is a growth, digestion, respiration, circulation and excretion. These are all known as a life processes. Now we will discuss about these all processes one by one. What are actually respiration, what is actually digestion, what is circulation, what is excretion. So let's start with the nutrition. Nutrition means we are going to study about the digestion. Okay, first of all we will learn nutrition, what kind of a nutrition is necessary for our body, for the survival of our body, for the energy to perform the daily function, right? For performing any particular function we need energy, as you know. For that energy we have to need nutrition, we have to take nutrition. These nutrition undergo the digestion process, their digestion will happen, and after that when complete digestion was completed, then the nutrition, some energy will be released, and these energy are stored in the some chemical form in our body, and it will be help you to give a type of energy to proceed the work or to continue the work in our daily life. So let's start nutrition. Nutrition in plant and nutrition in animal. As you see in our surrounding, actually we have a five kingdoms, right? Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. But we are talking about only the two kingdom, plants and animal, because they are large. We can see these animal with our naked eyes. So collectively we are talking about these type of organism. So we are going to discuss how plant are taking the nutrition, how animals are taking the nutrition. So nutrition in plant and nutrition in animal. That's why here with the help of a chart I divided the nutrition in a two part. What is the role of a nutrition, how nutrition plant are taking the nutrition, how animals are taking the nutrition. Plant, generally you know that everyone have familiar about that plant are generally autotrophic. What is the meaning of autotrophic? They are performing photosynthesis, they can prepare their own food. Actually how they are preparing their own food, just think, they are taking a carbon dioxide and water from the environment. They are the inorganic form of a chemicals. Remember it, carbon dioxide and water are the inorganic form of a chemicals. Okay, so they are taking inorganic form of a chemicals, water and carbon dioxide from the environment, and with the help of a sunlight They are converting the inorganic form of a chemical into the organic form of a chemical. So what are the examples of organic form of a chemical? Glucose. Glucose is an example of an organic form of a chemical. So I can tell what is photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a process by which inorganic form of a chemical are converted into the organic form of a chemical with the help of a sunlight. Okay? So, plants are performing the photosynthesis, they can prepare their own food, that's why they are known as the autotrophs. Okay? And one thing more I want to tell you, plants are the ultimate one individuals or organism present in our environment who can capture the ultimate source of energy from the sun. Because sun is the only the ultimate source of energy, and who are capable of absorbing the energy from the sun, that are the plant. Okay, they are absorbing the energy and convert it into the chemical energy, then this energy is available for the heterotrophs. When we are eating the plant, then we are getting the energy from the plant. Okay, now come to the nutrition in animals. We know that animals are heterotroph, means they cannot prepare their own food. They are dependent on the plant or other animal for their food. We already know that we are eating a rice or chapati, whatever we are taking in our diet, they are coming from the plants, or who are carnivorous, they non-vegetarian, they are taking the nutrition from the animals, means somewhere these animals are taking the nutrition from the plants, means any heterotrophic organism are that organism which depend on other organism for their food. So, in this way, nutrition is different in plant and animal. Major difference is that conclusively I can tell, plant are the autotroph, they can prepare their own food. Okay, they are taking the energy from the sun, converting the inorganic substance into the organic substance. Inorganic are carbon dioxide and water, organic are glucose and oxygen. Okay, and another one, when we are going to discuss about heterotrophs are that organism who not able to prepare their own food, they depend on other plant or animal for their food. Okay, and they are taking a inorganic chemical directly from the plant. Okay, so hope this video help you to understand what is life process. Okay, why we are telling these process as a life process? Why? Because they are essential for our life. Okay, and first of all, I already start about the nutrition. Told you nutrition in plant and animal. In next video, I will tell you the mode of a nutrition in detail. Okay, I hope this video help you to somewhere increase your knowledge. So stay tuned, watch the next video. Thank you and have a nice day.